Hello everyone, I've decided to record a different type of video today because I've decided that I really want to start learning how to 3D model and create my own models for 3D printing. I found a really cute picture of this fire dragon online and decided that it would be my inspiration for this sculpt. Now I'm pretty good with Tinkercad and know a fair few tips and tricks, so I thought it would be a good place to start. Tinkercad is definitely not the best program to do organic 3D models, but later on I will show you how I can use this for a solid base and add all the details that will really make this sculpt pop. So I start to build out the head of this dragon. As I want to turn it into an articulated print down the track, I'm only going to focus on the head. I want to have the main features blocked out, like the eyes, nostrils, the main horns on the head. Now it's looking pretty good, but don't worry, this isn't the end of it. In fact, I think this video is going to be a few parts long, as this isn't really a quick process, especially since I'm so new. So now that I've kind of got the main features where I want them, it's time to add little eye sockets for our dragon. And I like to kind of color things as I go, just so I can kind of visualize what this base model is going to look like. I also noted on my little inspiration picture that we've kind of got little tiny bags underneath this little dragon's eyes, as well as like this ridge that goes all the way from the eyebrows all the way down to the nostrils. So I thought I can add that in now just so I know exactly where these features are going to go. But like I said earlier, don't worry, it's not just going to look like a cylinder popping out of our little head here. Everything is going to be blended in really nice and smooth. I also noticed that, you know, there's not necessarily like flush connections between our nostril and our snout there. But that doesn't really matter. This is just the base model and that can be fixed in the next application. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to add a few more of the horns that I kind of want to see in this dragon. Now reminding, I'm not going to do the back of the head because that's going to be cut out for our articulated scales to join in there. It's looking pretty good, so I'm going to just flatten the back of the head where I'm going to put that connection, just so I know that I don't need to sculpt anything in that area. And I'm also going to flatten the base just so that's all nice and clean, because that's going to be sitting on the print bed. Now I'm pretty happy with the blocky model, and it's time to download it and send it to my iPad. So I downloaded the STL file. I'm going to import this base model into Nomad Sculpt, which is an app on my iPad. And yes, I know what you're thinking, could you have just done all this on Nomad? Short answer is yes, but I'm very quick with Tinkercad and absolutely love the align tool, so that this base will now give me a solid framework that I can now add all of the details on top of it. So you could see there, I was just kind of repositioning the nostrils and filling in those holes that weren't quite flush that we pointed out in Tinkercad. And now that's kind of fixed and it's no longer an issue. You'll also notice that whatever I do to one side of the model, I can do to the other side at the exact same time. So there's a really cool function in Nomad where I can mirror everything that I do on one side of my model to the other side of the model, which is really, really useful, especially if you're doing some kind of face that are going to have the same details on each side. So I'm trying to get the mouth in the exact right position and give it a little bit of a lip because I want to carve out some scales. You can see here too, I wasn't really happy with the overall shape of the head, so I just did a little bit of a rearranging there. Now I'm going to start carving out the little scales along the mouth that I could see in my little reference picture. I don't really want them to pop out too much, but I'm also aware that this might not show up very well on a 3D print, so it's going to be a bit of a trial and error process. So we'll put them in now and we might have to take them out a bit later. In the reference model too, there's a lot of spikes around the head and I really, really like these details, so I'm going to try and get some spikes going on at the bottom of our chin and trying to really think of that 45 degree angle, because when you 3D print things, 45 degrees seems to just be the magic number where it's really hard for our print to fail and end up with terrible overhangs. Now, I've decided to give my little baby dragon these massively chunky lips, and I don't know about you, but it just looks like Jar Jar Binks. But I think it's turning out really, really well so far, and I've started to add a little bit of details of those scales. How easy were those scales to draw in? Anyway, I think that's enough for part one. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss what I'm printing or sculpting next.